everybody. Welcome to the call. I cannot believe it is Wednesday. I spent the day with the school system working on Corona, COVID-related plans, masks. Do you go to the building? Do you not go to the building? All those kinds of things. So I've had a crazy, crazy day. I've been at it all day long with this thing. I gotta tell you. Hey, shout out to Peter in Australia, in Sydney. I want to say thanks for being here, Peter, and welcome. Darcy and Chad and so many others and Kat. I got all these emails. I didn't try to, I apologize. Now I see why you guys said it. This has nothing to do with coaching tonight. My emails were designed to get some insight. So I got like 1,700 responses on these questions, and I'm going to share the results with you in just a second. And then I've got some cool training, unorthodox, out of the box, super bloody cool coming. But I want to kind of start in with this, and I'm going to give away some gifts right now at the beginning. And I know, depending on, you know, some of you in the UK, I see y'all catch the replay, man. You don't have to stay up all night long unless you're like 30 or something. Okay. All right. So, hey, Frank, shout out Francis, right? There's so much, man. There's so much going on. Okay, guys. So what I did is I built some questions that were on my mind. I had a round table here with some marketers that live near me. We ordered some lunch in, we had some social distancing, and we chatted. And these are some of the questions we talked about, and we expounded. We spent like half a day, and we dug into some things. And I said, hey, you guys, and you know, Eddie and Mike, I said, my friend Michael, I said, what's causing you the most concern right now? So many of you answered these, right? Many of you answered this. Was it the economy, your health, your ability, your knowledge? And it was pretty interesting, you guys. Economy wasn't even number one. It was my ability. Look at the stats. This is with a lot of responses, unique responses. My ability was first, closely followed by the economy, then my knowledge and health. I was going to say health first or second. So I had no idea. No idea at all. And this is good information, you guys. I get invited to go play golf, and I'm like a really bad golfer, you guys. So for me, why are you stressed, Brian, about playing golf? I'm like, well, my ability. All right. So this was one, and I asked a few others, and I'm going to show you guys the results. But I also had some responses, and Vanessa helped gather these for me, and she didn't give me the names, so I don't have everybody's names here, but I want to shout out. You guys will know if they're yours. Working for myself was was necessary. I don't play well with the other kids. I've been full-time online since 2001. What about this one? I'm tired of the rat race. I wanted the ability to challenge my professional life, control my income. I hate incompetence. All of my bosses have been promoted to their own level of incompetence, which tends to happen. Able to maintain my integrity. That looks like Alan on the bottom up in Montreal. Freedom to do what I want and like, spend more time with my family, start a nonprofit. I didn't know that, Alan. That's pretty awesome. Somewhere just under 2,000, Darcy. All right. I asked this one. In a perfect world, what single change would you make in your business to improve your overall quality of life? And I'll be honest. For me, probably would have been more profit. You know, I didn't say mine, right? On this one, it'll be more profit for me. All right. So next, let's see. I'm looking at them for the first time. The actual real answer is more profit, 40%, followed by prospecting and selling almost tied, and fulfillment a close third. So these are interesting, but everybody wants to make more money, you know, that they keep. Right? So easy. And I saw some takeaways. Tired of being a good employee, making other people rich. The moment I turn my laptop off at the end of the day, my income stops. This is Chet on the bottom. I know he's here. I saw him. I learned early on that in order to succeed in corporate, you could not voice your opinion or ever tell management no, right? How true is that? I wanted the, and up top, I wanted the ability to have an almost hands-free income stream, okay? So I read tons and tons of these, and I'm going to continue going through them over the next week. But what about this one? What's your favorite part of your life? I got this right. I wonder if you guys did too. I think we all got this right. What do you think? Give me a shout out right now. What do you think? Freedom? Yeah, I would have said that. I think Willie Reese, Enrico, right? And Larry Willard. I think you guys are spot on. That's what I think. Let's see. I'm about to see it. And, oh, wait a minute. Did I go back? I went backwards. Hang on. Here it is. Let's see. Number one by far was family and friends. So I love that we all have our head on straight, right? Freedom and working for myself, man, those are big. But at the end of the day, family and friends, right? And success and money, looks like most of us aren't chasing money. We want freedom. We want the time with our family. We want the ability to do our own thing. Now, this one got a little interesting. And these are questions that I did locally, right? So look at this one. I asked this one. When you're considering a service to either add to your existing business model or as a completely new endeavor, what is more appealing to you? So I gave you a choice. Less work and you make a little less money. So you like to leave fulfillment to an expert, and I would prefer DFY right on the left. Or on the right, I'm okay with more work. I want to keep the maximum amount of money of profit possible. I prefer do it yourself with deep dive training and extensive education, right? There's no wrong answer. These are both important, but it goes to the mindset. It goes to the mindset. All right. Look at this. I knew it would be a winner. I didn't realize it'd be 73% on the DFY. So ease of use is critical. The ability to get help on the fulfillment and know with certainty that you don't have to guess. The ability to just get it right, right? I love it. So I had some cool responses. I wanted to improve the lifestyle of my family. I want the freedom to do what I like. Time is the short answer. Scott Hall said, I want toll gates. The freedom of being close to my family, right? A lot of the common messaging, right? So net, and I tried to net it out, and I won't spend any more time on this, but it's important to me. 57% of you, and this is a calculator, doubt your knowledge and ability to succeed. I want to stop that hopefully today. 66% of you, 2 out of 3, value freedom and your family and friends over money and success. I love that. Kudos to all of you. And 3 out of 4, 73% chose less work and are willing to have, right, a little less cash if you can leave fulfillment to the experts and have more time for family, friend, right? I should have added both in. Dorn, I didn't add it in, man. Hey, nothing's perfect. I'll fix it next time. So the takeaway, right? To overcome fear, you need confidence in your ability. You need to value your time more than money. You want a solution that gives you more freedom to live your life. You're looking for DFY. You get all these things, right? And this is part of something I'm going to try to put together over the next couple months. Tonight, I've got a very special friend of mine that I've never introduced you guys to. He actually super cool. I've been on trips and vacations and hung out with him. I've just never chosen. It's just never worked out, and it's not intentional. It just never worked out. But before I bring my friend out, I want to give away some gifts. And what I thought tonight we would do is I'm going to give out some random prizes for people that I see engaged in the Q&A box. So I'll randomly just pick you based on your answers while Chris is talking. But right at the beginning, I want to take 5 of you, and I'm going to give you an hour. And if it goes an hour and a half, it goes an hour and a half. And I want to just spend time where there's no cost. I want to give to you guys time with me, and I'll bring on 1 or 2 of our team and see if we can help you that maybe are stuck, right? Tom Picarillo, I love it. So let's pick some winners. So here's what I did. I went to my handy dandy random name picker, and this is a free spammy looking website, but it works. I've used it many, many times, and I've got a lot of names in here, and you got multiple entries for doing different things. So you'll see that Ryan Wagelman, who's probably not on the call because he's in Europe and Netherlands, is he's got his entries, right? So I'm going to pick a few winners right now, right? Larry, right? It's totally cool. No rig at all. I literally copy and paste them in. So I'm going to hit start, and here goes. You'll see the names. This is not me. And I'll scroll to the top, and I'll see the winner is Dina Higgins. So I'm going to write these down because Vanessa is with her family right now, and I don't want to say, Vanessa, write this down, because she will not be here. So I will write, Dina, you don't have to be here. We will reach out to you, and I don't think we've ever spoken, so I love this. So Dina, congrats. Let me pick another one. I'm going to hit random again, pick random, and I'm going to pick five of you guys right now. Oh, I love it. Another person I don't really know, Ta Chu. So Ta, awesome. I appreciate your entries and you being here. Let's do another one. Here they come. I'm going to go quick because I want to get to the meat, because you're going to love tonight. Omar Jackson. Omar, welcome. It's been a while. I love how many people answered this. You guys, a lot of people answered this. So this is what's super cool. Where's the pick another one? All right. Am I missing it? There it is. Pick another one right there. Here it goes. Oh, Nadia. All right, hang on. Okay, Nadia, hang on. All right, and I'm going to pick one more for the coaching, and we'll go from there. Oh, that's cool, Darcy. I'll check that out. Darcy, yes. Darcy remembers Nadia is a 17-year-old who joined us recently. I don't know her personally, but this is completely random. Basically, every time you took action, you got an entry in my Google Doc, and I grabbed all your first and last names and put them in here. I just pasted them in. Here goes the last one for this, and we'll have prizes all throughout while we go through the training. Is that Frank? I think, Frank. Frank, I know Frank's here because I just chatted with him online. Frank from Baltimore, if you guys remember Frank the Tank, who was at the live event a couple months back. Super cool guy. I love Frank. So awesome. So what I want to do is move. Yeah, Frank's here. He's like, yep. And I'm going to share it out. That's super cool, you guys. Oh, Darcy, you totally love Frank. All right. So what I want to do is I want to play off this. I'm going to do a bunch of evening training over the next month, a mix of guest speakers, free strategy content, step-by-step copy this. It's going to be a mix of all kind of stuff. However, tonight, with no further ado, because my big mouth is chatting, let me unmute a friend of mine who I've known a long time. And let me find him. Give me a second. Chris, are you there? Let's see if I can find Chris.
All right. Can you hear me okay?
There you go. Chris, I hear you. Guys, this is a good friend of mine. This is Chris Ormiston. And I've been friends with Chris for years. I think you're gonna blow a gasket. You're gonna do gaga. If you ever wanted to learn from somebody that has clients the like of what most marketers and guru types could only dream of, tonight's your night. And I will tell you, Chris is in our mastermind. He was updating me on our meeting today. I was at the school board. Chris is the guy that teaches the rest of the guru type marketers all the little tips and tricks. So if you ever wanted to learn from the source and go to the deep end of the pool, please meet Chris Ormiston. Thank you, Chris.
Hey, Brian, it's great to be with you, and it's great to be with all of you who have joined us today. I am so excited to be with you today, and let me go to the next slide here. We're going to talk about some top secret technology today. So my goal today is to completely blow your mind, and I'm going to do this by talking about things, some technology that we've built and created that is rivaling all other types of marketing at this time. And it's some pretty crazy stuff. And so what I want to do is just give a big shout out to Brian. Brian's has been a good friend of mine for a long time. And it's just great to be with Brian. Right? I mean, you guys know Brian is like the greatest guy ever. He's a community leader. He's a family man. He's a good friend. He's loyal. And it's just great. Oh, did I put BFF on here? Dang it. I didn't.
Oh, I remember that. No, but
seriously, seriously, Brian is like the greatest guy ever. So thank you for allowing me to be here and talk with you guys. So the big question that we always get when we start this, because as you go through here, your mind is going to be blown. You're going to say, wait a second, can I get a copy of this presentation? That's the big question, right? And the answer is yes. I want to make sure that you guys have, it's really not going to be a direct copy of this presentation. It's actually going to be way better. It's going to be like pretty much everything I say today written with beautiful graphics and explanations and things like that all built in. So you can learn even more in depth, because I'm not going to go into the technical side of this today. We're going to stay on how this works. And so this is what I've titled the Local Business Resurgence Initiative. And it's a hard word to say. So we're going to give this to you at the end. So hang tight. We're going to give this to everybody so you can walk away with this and you can take it with you. Okay. Okay. That being said, what we're going to talk about today are unexpected sources of traffic, targeting the perfect customer, reaching out in new ways that you probably didn't even know was possible, and also talking about how it fits into a COVID-19 resurgence initiative. It's so hard to say, but that's what it is. So that's our goals today. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about targeting perfect clients, perfect potential customers, without having an email list, without retargeting pixels, without phone numbers or addresses. You don't need any tech skills to make this all work. And you can leverage the results that we've gotten from some pretty amazing clients that we've had. Now, what this is going to do, it's going to put you in a very powerful position, because it's going to allow you to start picking the clients that you want to work with, because there's going to be a lot of clients that are going to want what you have. And we'll go through this today and explain what that means. But the reason I know that this is going to work for you is because this is who it's worked for in the past. These are our clients. And Brian kind of mentioned some of the people that we've worked with in the past. This isn't all the larger companies, but these are some that you guys would probably recognize. Microsoft, I think we all recognize that one. Insight, IBM, Outback, Carrabba's, Bonefish. Now, let me clarify this. We didn't go to Outback Steakhouse down the street and say, hey, you need some marketing. No, this has all been done through corporate. So when we marketed for Outback, we actually marketed for 2,600 locations. Okay, we're going to talk about how we did that a little bit today and what it meant. So and that's the same with all of these. We're talking at the corporate level for all of these clients right here. So there's a lot of power in what we're going to talk about today, because it's backed up by large corporations who are capitalizing on this technology. And they paid, I'm not gonna kid you, they paid a lot of money to do this. But what we're gonna talk about today is not gonna fall into that category. We've basically buttoned this up so that this can be affordable to all local businesses. And we'll talk about that. It's pretty cool. So who am I? Let me just go through there just for a second. I started up a couple of companies here, and I'm mostly a developer, right? And so when I was early on, we were crushing it in the SEO world. And it was actually, this is before we even coined the phrase SEO, right? And so as you can see on my screen right here, that's my website. And this office is actually Google. So this is Google's office way back when Google had like 19 employees. So they gave me a call one day and they said, hey, we noticed that you're at the top of the search engines, and it wasn't their search engine, it was the other ones. They said, we would like you to be in our search engine. I'm like, okay, who are you? And they said, oh, my name is, you know, we're Google. And we're like, and I literally covered the phone and looked at my business partner sitting next to me. I'm like, you ever heard of Google before? He's like, no. And so anyway, I was talking to them and they said, hey, we want to put you up there and let us know if there's any problems. And they gave me their phone number, so I could call them if there is, quote, any problem. So what we can continue to do over the next year, they kept my website up there for an entire year. So it's called Human Review for an entire year so that everybody was looking at my website all day long on this, you know, TV. So basically, what ensued is that we basically helped them build their initial algorithms when they got started so that they could focus on the websites that were the most legitimate and that were the most relevant. So we did that for a year with Google, and then we finally broke off and started doing our own stuff and like that. So basically, it was inconceivable how big Google got after that. And you know, we really don't take any credit about how big they got, but it was really fun to be able to participate in something that was new. It was a startup. It was interesting. They were brilliant. And it was just, it was a privilege to be able to work with them in the early stages of this. So anyway, it's a fun story I like to share, and it's something that kind of makes us unique and different. So what I want to do is I want to start today with the story of my brother, Glenn. My brother is a contractor. Well, he's not really a contractor. He runs a contracting company. Well, he is a contractor by trade, but he runs a company that has over 2,000 employees. And he and his office, they go to this deli to go get sandwiches and food and stuff for, like, you know, lunches and meetings and things like that, right? So it's their neighborhood favorite. It's family owned. And when he went there, he was just kind of chatting with them as he was picking up his order. And they were complaining that they had dropped 80% because of the COVID-19. It was family owned, and they were not very wealthy, and they had worked hard from the ground up to just get in this place. And you can tell by the back wall that this is not a luxury, you know, upscale type place, right? But they make great food from what I understand. They didn't have enough savings to survive this decline, and they went bankrupt and had to shut down their store. And my brother was devastated. We were talking about it one night. He's like, man, I wish there was something I could do. He says, we can only buy so much food. He says, I wish we could have just stepped in and saved their business. And so what we're going to talk about today is ways that you can help businesses just like this save their business in ways that you probably haven't even considered before, and turn them into bustling businesses like this so that they can survive this downturn during these crazy economic times. So we're going to talk about some ways that you can help this happen with the businesses in your community, so you can directly reach out, similar to what Brian does, just in a little bit different way, to reach out to your own community to help them survive. All right. So what we're going to talk about today is a little known emerging technology where you get superpowers. You're going to get a leg up on your sales, so this is going to be easier than ever, and you're going to be a hero in your community by being able to bring this amazing technology to them. And it's going to be done in unexpected ways to target your customers, and you are going to be a hero. And you'll see why as we go on. And so these are the types of businesses that it works for. It works for political candidates. It works for casinos. It works for wealth planners and banks and architectural firms and tattoo parlors, 4x4 shops and bookstores and nightclubs and golf courses. So basically, it works for pretty much every type of business you can think of, with the exception of like two that we've figured out along the way. Now, we've done thousands of campaigns like this, and so we have a lot of experience in how it works and things like that. The two types of businesses that it doesn't work for are emergency type services like plumbing, because the plumbers go to the people's houses. People don't go to a plumbing store, right? And also HVAC, so heating, air conditioning, that kind of thing, that's another emergency service. And so those are the only two that it doesn't work for, but everything else it kind of works for. So, and I know you don't understand it right now, but we'll go through this and this will become real clear why. So the way that this works is we are able to identify a very, very specific targeted audience. From that audience, we can cherry pick the best leads, and then we activate what we call the business tractor beam. Just like on the Star Trek picture right here, we lock onto the leads and we suck them in to the businesses. And then what we do is we measure the success to see how effective this tractor beam is. Now, this is an incredible technology, and you're going to see why. So basically, with this tractor beam, what we do is when we target them, we make them an offer that can't refuse. refuse. Remember, like on The Godfather, that movie?
Make you an offer you can't refuse.
So basically, that's what we're going to do for these companies so that we can bring them in. Now, we're going to show you how this can be fulfilled very easily because we're going to do all this stuff for you. We're going to leverage our team, and we're going to have professional reporting that we show to your customers so you don't understand, you don't have to understand what all the numbers mean, because we're going to make you look like a hero. So these are all the things that you're going to learn how to do right here. I can leverage your team. The reason I say that it's your team on the top here, because when we start working together, our team is going to be your team. We're going to be a team together, right? So this is an incredible thing that you can do, is come in here with experts and be able to leverage that. So what we're going to do is we're going to target specifically the business's competitors' customers. Now let's take a second and step back and think about what I just said. What would it mean to a company if we were able to go in, target whoever their competitors are, and zero in on their customers and say, hey, we're better, you should check us out? This is how we're going to build a new audience. And we're going to build it for these businesses. And this is very much like having a surveillance system in your competitor's store. What would it mean to you if you were able to go to a business, a restaurant, a 4x4 shop, a yoga studio, and show them that you have a surveillance system in their competitor's places of business? Do you think they might be interested in that? If you think that a business that you know of might be interested in targeting the clients of their competitors, type in a Y right now into the question, Jerry. I'm just curious. So Willie's saying yep. Nalia, Kim is saying yep. Herb, Paul, Trev, oh. Jamie, Bob, Kurt, Frank, yeah. I think we would all agree that this would be unbelievable if you could basically provide them a list of all their competitors' clients and people who go to their stores and restaurants and places like that, right? Unbelievable. But that's what we do. Not only we can do that, but we have this process where we can target other locations like this ballpark. Now, this is in Arizona. This is the stadium, the Cardinal Stadium, where the Cardinals football player football team practices and plays their games. This is what we call hack the ballpark. And the reason why we would target a ballpark is because there is a certain type of person who go to these ballparks. First of all, they have discretionary income. Second of all, they tend to be rabid fans. They stand behind their teams. They have the time for this type of a luxury. And they tend to be very, very good customers to restaurants, to pretty much every business that's out there, because they're rabid fans. And you want them in your business because they'll become a rabid fan of you when they love you. So this is just one strategy that you can use as an idea to target people in a specific place. You see that little, you know, area that we've kind of blocked off around the stadium? This is what we do. We block off the stadium, and then we can track everybody who has entered into that stadium. Pretty cool, right? We do the same thing with the businesses. We put a circle around those businesses, and we track everybody who goes into those businesses. So basically, the way that it works is we can follow, or we can basically use mobile devices, and we capture a special ID that's on everybody's phones. And everybody has their phones with them all the time, right? And so what we do is we put this into what we call a pre-built audience, an audience just for you. And restaurants and other businesses love this, because now we're hyper-targeting the people who they love to come into their restaurants and their businesses first. Now, on top of that, we can use behavioral patterns to layer on top of it. So let me give you an example. For instance, if we're at the stadium and we have all these rabid fans, but we only want to target the women, well, we can do that. So we can layer on top of that and say, okay, we have 254 million or, you know, 1,000 people or whatever that are in this list. Let's only target the women on there because we have an offer that caters to women. Boom, we can do that. In fact, we can even do things like, have they been in a specific restaurant? Are they a professional, like maybe a personal injury lawyer or an accountant or a doctor or, you know, something like that? Do they drive a Mercedes? Do they drive a Toyota? Do they have a dog? Are they in a particular socioeconomic category? Are they male or female? Do they have kids? Are they married? So there's lots of behaviors and there's lots of patterns and aspects to these audiences that we can layer on top and narrow specifically down to the exact type of person that these businesses are looking for. Now, at that time, what we do is, let's circle back to why we use cell phones for this technology. First of all, 91% of the smartphone users out there have a phone within their reach 24 hours a day. So I just read the slide, right? So let me ask you guys, how many of you guys are within arm's reach right now as we're talking with your phone? If you're within arm's reach of your phone, type in a Y. I would venture to say most of us are. I know I am. Owen isn't. What? Okay, Owen, you're part of the 9% that are out there. Because there's 9% out there, right? Yep, of course. Yep. Bob, Larry, Michelle, Paul, Patty, Nalia. Oh, Nalia says she doesn't have a phone yet. Well, that's awesome. So you couldn't be. So basically, most everybody is, I mean, there's a ton of people who said yes in there. But basically, everybody's like within arm's distance of their phone. So what does that mean? That means if we have access to be able to know where that phone is, that means we know where they go, we know where they visit, and we can start building audiences based on where they visit. Pretty amazing, right? So basically, our phones, they go everywhere with us. It leverages location services so we know where that phone goes. And the phone just has to be turned on. They don't have to have a special app open. They don't need to be surfing the web. They don't need to be doing anything special on their phone. They just have to have their phone. And it has to be turned on. I mean, nobody really carries a phone that's turned off. So it's kind of a given. It's turned on, right? That's why we focus on cell phones, because it allows us to get an enormous amount of information on how to target people. Now, we're addicted to our phones. I mean, in this, as we've been talking today, you guys have probably checked your phone, I would say on average 5 to 10 times each. And by checking your phone, that means looking at it, turning it on, making sure that there's not an email or a text that you missed, things like that. Maybe you're even chatting with your family right now, right? But statistics show that we don't go 1 hour without checking our phone. And so basically, when people have their phones, this is where we activate the tractor beam. So this is where the amazing stuff happens behind the phone right here, is when we have our phones with us. And that's basically everywhere. So basically what we do is we'll go through there and we'll find the businesses, we'll find the people who go in those businesses, and then we'll build audiences. Say for instance, this was a particular restaurant, or it was a yoga studio, or it could be a dealership, or it could be an office of some kind, whatever it is. What we can do is we can say, who are all the people that walked in there over the last 12 months? Because we want to market to them. And it could be even the business that you're talking to. Like, for instance, restaurants out there, they haven't been keeping track of who goes in their restaurant. They just feed them and let them leave. So what if they want to bring back their own customers? Well, we can now, because we've been like little chipmunks out there storing away acorns for the last year. Those acorns are their clients, and we have their list ready to go right now. And we can give them their list back. Well, theoretically, we can market to those people that are that we have been targeting for the last entire year. You think businesses might be interested in marketing the people that have been to their business over the last year, which are the people who love them the best? Absolutely. So here's an example. Remember we talked about Outback Steakhouse a little bit? So we know everyone who's been here for the last 12 months. You think Outback would be interested in that? Yes, they were. They were extremely interested in that. And so basically what we're able to do is go back there and say, do you want to bring those people back maybe one more time a month? If they bring them back one more time a month, what do you think happens to their revenue? Take a wild guess. Go ahead and type in how much you think that their revenue increases if they can bring their clients back one more time per month. 19%, said Willie. Traffic Legend said 100%. Heidi says it doubles. Larry says that 10x, 200%, millions. Yeah, it's definitely millions. 50% increase, double. Those are all really good questions. It actually goes up by about 400%. So just being able to target their own restaurants is incredibly powerful. But what if you're to take it a step further, a big step for like a big leap forward? What if we were able to target the competitors' customers on top of that and say, what if we were able to target everybody who went into a Sizzler? Do you think if we targeted them like a week or two later and said, hey, you should come to Outback because we have a Bloomin' Onion and the Sizzler does not. Now, they don't really say that in the ad, right? But basically what you're doing is saying, come over and have a Bloomin' Onion, because who doesn't like those, right? We know that they're steak eaters because they went to eat steak at the Sizzler. So what do you think it would mean to them if we could say, hey, we know everyone who went to the Sizzler in the last 12 months? Not only that, what if we could also tell them who's been at the Texas Roadhouse in the last 12 months that's down the road 2 miles? So we know the people who've been there, they live in an area that's close enough for them to go eat here. What would that mean to Outback Steakhouse? And what if we went to Black Angus and said, hey, let's target everyone who's been to Black Angus and invite them down to have a Bloomin' Onion, right? I'm telling you, this is unbelievably powerful when we can target the competitors' customers. So this is what we're talking about today. And then what we do when we target them, we know who they are. Then all of a sudden the customers see ads to the Outback Steakhouse all over the place. Everywhere they turn, they're seeing ads to the Outback Steakhouse. So how is it that we're able to find the perfect audience? How do you guys think that you could find a perfect audience this way? Well, you really don't need to, because we're going to do it for you. You're going to leverage our experts who've done thousands of these campaigns that have been with us for many years. In fact, our newest employee has been with us for 2 years. That's how long they've been doing it. The last person that we hired was 2 years ago, and they've been working this nonstop for the last 2 years. So you have an experienced group of project managers. They're going to do all this stuff for you. So remember, we're going to do this without email lists. We're going to do it without retargeting pixels or phone numbers or addresses. You don't need any tech skills, because our team is going to do all this stuff for you. And you can leverage our results. And by leveraging our results, what that means is that you can tell people that we, meaning us and you working together, have worked with Microsoft, that we've worked with Outback Steakhouse, that we've worked with IBM and Orange Theory and all these other companies that you saw out there. Now you can use that because we're working together and you can leverage our results. All right. So basically what we're doing ultimately is we're increasing customer traffic. We're bringing people into the place of business that we're marketing for. All right. So when we target them, that's the ultimate goal. So remember, we can focus on the locations they are, and then we can build behavior patterns and layer them over the top and say, okay, we want everyone in this location, but we want people who fall in these different categories, right? So we can do all that stuff. They don't need to be at the location to see the advertisements either. We activate this tractor beam, and we can show them at work, at home, on their tablets, on their computers. It works everywhere, right? So this is an incredible way that we can stay in front of them on a regular basis. And so one of the big questions is, well, where are they going to see our ads? Well, these are just some of the millions of websites out there that they're going to see the ads on. And basically, if the way that it works, my favorite way to describe this is, have you ever gone to like Amazon or eBay or Zappos or any of those big companies like that? And then all of a sudden, a couple hours later to like the next day, all of a sudden those products you're looking at are popping up all over the website. It's like every website you go on, you're seeing all these products, right? You guys seen that before? It's pretty cool how they do that, right? Well, here's the cool part about it. That is where you are going to be. When you saw all those ads all over the place, these are the ads we're putting all over the place in your behalf. So once we find the right people, they start seeing these ads. No matter everywhere they go, they're going to see this. And so not only is it going to be all over the websites, it's going to be all over their apps too. Like if they're on Words with Friends, or if they're on ABC News or CBS Sports or ESPN, this is where the ads are going to be showing up on all these applications too. So they're on the web, they're on applications. I mean, they're going to be in front of them all over the place. Talk about branding. My heavens, this is unbelievable. When your company can get in front of them like six, even up to 12 times a day, they're seeing that this company so that they can be top of mind. So when we get started, what we want to do is we want to make sure that we're measuring success, because every business has a little bit different goal. Some of them, they want people to walk in their business, like restaurants, right? Other people want phone calls. Other people want people to fill out a form. Some people want engagement in some kind, maybe watching a video. Some people, they just want people to click on there for branding, and they want people to see them for impressions. So our team of professionals, they work with you to make sure that everybody's going to be super successful from the very beginning. And then we get into all the geeky stuff, like the impressions and clicks and click-through rate, post-click conversions and desktop count and mobile count. Who knows all this stuff, right? Well, you don't need to know it. But I tell you what, our project managers are going to talk to all this with your clients in English terms so that it's not going to confuse them. And they're going to show them and talk to them in very, very basic terms how this is affecting their company. And they're going to do this in a way where you can sit back and you can be the hero, because these project managers are going to be your project managers, and they're going to represent you extremely well. And they're going to do all this stuff for you. So let's talk about the COVID-19 stimulus, just so we can go through like maybe a quick scenario. Let's just take this problem with restaurants that are out there. Now, this can apply to lots of different businesses, but I just kind of randomly chose a restaurant because it illustrates this well. So Glory Days Grill right here, here's their problem. They didn't listen to us to build their list. They didn't collect email addresses. They didn't install social Wi-Fi. They didn't install, or they didn't, you know, put things on their website or do promotions to build their audience, because they didn't feel as necessary. They're like, well, people come and eat at our place all the time. What do we need you for? Right? Well, guess what? It's winter time. They need us now. Wouldn't you agree? If we had their list of clients, everyone who went there and ate at their restaurant for the last 12 months, you think they might be interested? Yeah. I mean, we already answered that before, right? They need us bad. This is a database, a massive database that we've put together for you guys, because we, from behind the scenes, we've been storing up these acorns. We've been collecting these lists. We have been tracking every business in the entire United States. We've been doing the United States, Mexico, we've been doing Australia, New Zealand, South America, South Africa, and many other countries throughout the world. And we've been doing this every day for the last, well, more than 12 months, but we have 12 months of data, because once it gets past 12 months, the data becomes less useful because people change their phones and stuff like that. So we have 12 months of data in our database ready to be used by you right now. So what would it mean to a company to be able to say, hey, let's go back and reach out to the people who have ate at our restaurant or come to our business over the last 12 months? It would mean the world to them. This is what it means to this restaurant. It means that people are lined up waiting to get in, because our job can be now to help bring them back in ways they never suspected before. So what we're going to do is we're going to, what Brian and I have done, we've kind of put together this agency quick start right here. Now, maybe I can ask you guys, if you were to go to a customer and you're be able to explain this in a general way, like how would you like to be able to advertise to your competitors' customers? Real simple to understand, right? How many of you guys think that you would be able to excite one person to be able to do that? That one person that you know of might be interested in something like that. So if you think that you could interest one person, go ahead and type the Y into the chat. Willie, Cynthia, Pat, Michael, Dan, Peter, Rico says yes three times. Awesome. Owen, Kurt, Chester, Herb, Darcy, Michael. So yeah, Darcy says 17. Yeah. No, absolutely. So basically, what we want to do is we want to make sure that we're going to cover your investment today with your first sale. So not only is this first sale going to pay for this, it's going to make you money on the first sale. You only need one person to be interested in this. Now, remember, we're going to build all your projects. We're going to do all your reporting. We're going to be meeting with your customers, and we'll even jump on the phone with you to help you land the deal, because we don't want you to be in a position where you're on the phone with a potential customer and not able to answer questions. So our project managers have committed to be on the phone with you when you need them. Now, this is 100% proven technology and systems that work, and they're in use by these large companies and hundreds of different local businesses, like the ones that you're working with. And we do all the fulfillment for you, so you can spend time with your friends and your family while we're out there doing all the work for you. This is going to increase your income, because this will be an ongoing project that you're going to be able to have recurring revenue from. So this will be making you money without you working on that side. So it's going to be something that you can use to build your business, that you can spend more time with your family, and leverage our team to do all the heavy lifting for you. Now, like I said, it's 100% done for you. All you have to do is bring the client, and we'll kind of take it from there. Now, we want you on the phone when we talk to them each month. I think you would probably agree it'd be important to maintain that relationship on your side, but we'll handle the entire phone call. We'll talk about the successes. We'll talk about things that we're changing, that we're updating, making suggestions to the different advertising processes, things all like that. And we will be the experts on the phone for you. Now, let's talk about the cost of one campaign. So basically, we have a couple of different costs out here. So basically, what we're going to do is we're going to pay the websites and the apps and everything like that to you know, put the ads out there for your client, for your customers that you bring on. And you basically charge them $9.97. And there's ways that you build in your profit at $4.97, so it doesn't look like you're making that much money, but you actually are. So basically, your profit on one deal every month is going to be nearly $500. Okay? So this is a super powerful way that you can build your business in ways that maybe you haven't expected, to have this reoccurring income with a business who absolutely loves you. So we're going to do some special training. It's actually on July 21st. And this is going to, I'll illustrate this later. It's going to be on July 21st, where we're going to take you down deep into how the technology works, how to set up projects, how to engage with your project manager, how to just basically everything about it, as far as like we're going to show you all these resources. Like, we've got crazy presentations that you can show to your customer that's going to blow their mind, much like your minds are being blown right now about targeting the customers that go to their clients' businesses, right? Or their competitors' businesses. So we're going to do all this training for you. And what you're going to get is the full use of our technology. Remember those servers that I showed you? Those servers are sitting out there for you and your customers, so that we can utilize all this math, these terabytes and terabytes of data that we've been storing every day for the last 12 months in your behalf. You're going to have a dedicated project manager to help you with all of your projects, to help you sell your deals, to consult with you. There's not going to be any monthly subscription costs. As far as when you get involved with us, it's going to be a one-time cost. That's it. And there's not going to be any management fees either. So you can make all the money off of the management fees. So this is going to strengthen the economy, and it's going to strengthen your business. Because the most important business that we're talking about today, I know we've been talking about Outback Steakhouse and these other businesses, but honestly, the most important business today is your business. This is why we're on the call right now, so we can build your business. This is how we build the economy, is by strengthening you, so that you have more money to put into your communities and to your you know, the different areas, the cities that you live in. And then secondarily, as a side effect, we're going to start building the businesses around in the same process. So it's a win-win all the way around. Everybody grows from this technology. So we're going to help other people keep their businesses alive. And so let me ask, how many of you guys want the ability to help local businesses in your community with this technology? So everybody who wants to do this, I want you to type in a special word today, because what I'm going to do is we only have 50 slots to do this, because our project managers When we met with them about a week ago in preparation for this, they said, do not bring on more than 50 people or we will kill you, because they only have so many hours in the day and they can only run so many projects. So they basically said, don't sell more than 50. And so what we're going to do right now is everybody who types in the word beam for beam me up, Scotty. So BEAM. We're going to lock you in right now to one of those positions. So if you type in beam, what we're going to do is we're going to paste in the link so that you can join us and you can get involved and start working with our project managers. And you can start leveraging this technology for your own businesses and the businesses that you work with. So Brian, if you could, do you have that link handy to paste in for these guys? Because there's a couple more FAQs that I wanted to cover while we're doing this. So Adam, Michael, Peter, you guys all typed in Beam. You guys have locked in your spot. Cynthia, Alan, Scott, Bob, Gary, Willie, all you guys, thank you for wanting to jump on and work with our team.
Hey, Chris, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you great.
I want to make sure it's the right one. It's the bit.ly Beam Me Up.
That's it.
All right, I got it. I'm going to type it in right now.
So go ahead and so everybody who typed in Beam, make sure you start from the top down, because you guys who typed it in the fastest, you guys are going to have preference and you guys have locked in. So I can promise you, if you typed in Beam and you want to join us today, you've locked in your spot. So let's go through while Brian's doing that. Thank you, Brian. Let's go over a couple of go ahead.
No, I said you got it. Don't worry about it.
All right, cool. So remember, this is going to be without emails, no retargeting, phone numbers, addresses needed to make all this stuff work or to have been in place to make this work. You're not going to need any tech skills, because we're going to fill in that gap for you, and you can leverage our results to help you promote this. Because when they see those big names and it's associated to you and your business, you are going to look big. I promise you. Remember all these businesses like Outback, Carrabba's, and Fleming's, and Microsoft, and Insight, and Orange Theory? I mean, everybody knows these companies, right? So here's a list of questions that we've kind of pre-prepared, because this is what everybody always asks. Is this Big Brother? No, it's not Big Brother. This technology is completely, it's completely authorized based on all of the privacy laws that are in every state of the entire United States and other countries. So basically, we don't know who's attached to those phones. Like, we don't know if it's Nancy, Drew, we don't know if it's Joe Bob, we don't know who it is, but we know that that phone has been in an area, so we can show ads to that phone and all of the devices that are connected to that phone, okay? So that's why it's not Big Brother. So it follows the privacy laws. Is this legal? Yeah, it's absolutely legal. We've been through legal counsel many times, and we work for a bunch of lawyers who vetted us out. So lawyers like to do this to target hospitals and things like that, right? As you can imagine. Crazy, right? So what would it mean to a lawyer, if they're a personal injury lawyer, if they could target the emergency room, especially if it's a level one trauma center? You think they could get some business there? I'm telling you, that's where their business is. So is it legal? Yes. We've been vetted out. We follow all the privacy laws to make sure that this is safe and it's legal for everybody. Is it available right now? Yes, it is available at this moment. We've been storing up all the data for the last 12 months, like we said. Now, what do you know about me? This is an important question that you all need to understand, because I'm sure that as we're going through this, you kind of got a little bit of the creep factor, which is, man, you know where I am because I carry my phone? And the answer is, no, we don't know where you are, but we know where a phone is. And the phone is what we use as a conduit to show ads, right? So basically, this is what we know about the phone. You see this number on here that starts with ASD? We know that that code right there, which is called an advertiser ID or an ad ID, we know where that phone is, and plus the location that it's at. That's really all we know. And that's all that we need to know to pull this whole crazy thing off. So this is what we know about you. Do we know where you live? No, we don't know where you live, nor do we care. But does that mean we can't show you ads in your home? No, we can show you ads while you're sitting in home and your kids are doing their homework and they're you know on the internet. They can see all that stuff. They can see all those ads rather. Do we know where they work? No, but they're going to see ads at work. Does this work outside the US? Yes, it works in every country that Google is in with the exception of Canada and the UK because they have ultra strict privacy rules there that prohibit this type of you know tracking and connecting with devices. So we respect those laws that they have in place. We expect them to relax at some point, but right now they said no, flat out no, we can't do this. So basically everywhere else in the world is a go. Canada and UK is no. I don't know how they're marketing at all with this strict laws. It's like, I feel bad for them. Does this work on Mars? No, it does not work on Mars, but it works everywhere else on Earth. So that's the good thing. Let's go through a quick case study because I want to show you some things that you can use this for that are a little bit out of the box, but I want to get the creative juices flowing for what you can do. So this first case study is a way that we can target businesses and they can recruit talent for their company. So a business came to us and they said, hey, we are a garage door installation company. We do garage door and repair, right? So they said, we have so much business, we need new techs. How can we get in front of techs so that we can hire them? Because we pay more, we have company trucks, we have great insurance, we have all these benefits, right? We're better than everyone else. Everyone's gonna wanna come to us. So what we did is we focused on the warehouses where they pick up their supplies every day. So we went, we carved out like the parking lot in the warehouses where they walk in and they get the garage doors and the supplies and the springs and you know, all the whatnots that they need to do to repair and replace garage doors. Because that's where the technicians go, right? So what we did is we started targeting all the technicians that would go there every day. And in, what is it, 3 months? Is that what it is? 3 months, they had over 220 resumes. You think that's a win for them? To have qualified technicians in the field that are doing this every day start applying to them? Yeah, I'll tell you what, this is a big boost for them. So that's just one different type of way that you can still use this technology for a company. It's the same technology that we're basically using our tractor beam to pull in the technicians and you know the installation techs instead of a client, but that is their client, right? Now here's another one where an example where we layered in an audience. So we targeted a fashion mall. It was an upscale mall, and the client was a boutique there. It was a beauty salon, and they said, okay, we want to target everyone who walks into this mall who's female between the ages of 25 and 65 who have a certain socioeconomic status, which is over $100,000 a year in income for themselves or their family. And they just gave us like a list of different things, right? Female, visited the mall, household income, age, and that they're married. They wanted the stability of people who are married, right? So what we did is we focused on everybody who went into that mall that fit this category. Those are the only people who saw the ads. So that shows you the power of how much you can zero in. And what that means is that is the greatest use of their marketing dollar when they can get to the exact people who they want to walk into that beauty salon. Pretty crazy, right? So I just want to kind of go through that so you can get an idea. So here is, let me see here, before we go to the next screen here, how many people, Brian, do you think typed in Beam? Now I'm going to give you guys one last chance to type in Beam if you haven't.
I was exhausted. I answered most of them, Chris. I'll finish them right now. Sorry, I was doing it one at a time and there was a lot, you guys. I don't know how many.
Yeah. Well, thank you. So don't type it in again if you've already done it. You already locked in your spot. If you haven't done it yet, this is your last chance. So anybody who hasn't locked in their spot, here is the link that you can get in today. So what we're going to do though is if you've typed in Beam and locked in your spot, you guys are going to get preference. Your guy's going to get it first. Everyone else who signs up, you're going to get secondary preferences. All right. So remember, you're going to get instant access to all of the resources. We have sales decks. We have it in PDF format, in PowerPoint. You can modify those. You can brand them with your logos. You'll have all access to the previous training that we've done in the past so that you can know how to sell, how to position things, lots of Q&A stuff from other people who are doing this. You're going to get a dedicated project manager. Everything is going to be done for you by that project manager so that you have one place to go to for all your projects. You're going to get access to all of the audience layering and everything that goes on top of that to make sure that all of your campaigns are perfect for your clients. And you're going to get it for a one-time price today of $397. All right. So you're not going to have this ongoing $97 a month and all that kind of stuff. No, you're going to have a lifetime membership if you join us today. All right. Typically, we sell this for $997, but this is our special Brian and Chris COVID pricing. We're giving it to you guys at 60% off. We want to do this because this is our way to reach out to you and your community to start building your business during these crazy economic times. And I'm not just saying that this usually sells for $997 to make it seem like, oh, it's worth a lot more. I'm telling you, we legit sold this for $997 until now. So we're going to make this available to the first 50 people. All right. So remember, I promised you guys a free gift, this local business resurgence initiative. I wanted to give this to you guys today because this is the entire presentation and more. There's only so much things, you know, we can talk about today. There's some crazy tech I couldn't even talk about today that's going to blow your mind all over again. And we're going to show you how to do that during our training on the 21st of July. So if you guys want this free initiative that we put together, it's like 42 pages. It's not a joke. I mean, this is like legit stuff, and it's actually fun to look. There's like fun pictures and everything. Go to this link right now because it's on the bottom right of your page on the sell page. So go ahead and just go ahead and click on the link that you were given by Brian, and go get your free gift. Download it right now. If you guys have already joined us and signed up to work with our project managers, go in and type in "I'm in." Anybody who's taken the initiative and jumped in, type in "I'm in." I'd like to see who we're going to be working with. All right, Walter. Fantastic. All right, Cynthia. Awesome. It's great to be connected with you guys. I can't wait to meet you guys on the training so we can go into even more. Owen, awesome. Great to have you on board.
I'm still giving the link out, you guys. I'm hurrying, I promise.
All right. Remember, you're going to get instant access to all the sales resources, everything that you can have, so that you can explain this in a very simple way and just blow the minds of these businesses.
I love it. Welcome, man, they're just flowing, Chris. Ronald and Ken Fong. Ken, I'll check that out with Chris in a second, okay? And Adam, hey Adam Griffin. Hang on, let me get the rest of the beans.
Welcome, Ronald. Awesome.
Frank said, "Brian, I'm almost in. I was eating, but I'm definitely on board." I don't want to steal you from your food, my friend.
How dare you eat at dinner time?
Well, East Coast, hey, it's 9 o'clock where Frank lives in Baltimore, so I say it's better to wait till tomorrow. Too late tonight, man. You're done. I try to eat before 8 every night, between 5 and 7, ideally. Kim Armstrong, welcome, Kim. Kim. I just saw Kim.
Awesome.
Hey, Chris, while we're helping them, I saw a great question. I saw it like 9 times, and I know you're probably going to answer it, but I want to make sure. So the people in Canada, there's a bunch of them that went in. It doesn't work in Canada, which is more of a legality base, but they can still get U.S. clients. Is that true or no? Or is there a law against it?
They can use this for all their U.S. clients. We just can't target the businesses the same way in Canada. So it's more restrictive there, but any of your clients in U.S., all the other countries we can do this for sure. So there's kind of an elephant in the room, and I want to be real clear on how we get paid for these projects, because I know this is a question that comes up, and I want to be as transparent as I possibly can, because obviously we have to stay in business. And so how do we get paid if you are not paying management fees to us, that you're not paying a monthly fee for the software? Like, how does that work, right? I'm sure a lot of you guys are kind of thinking that. Well, let me tell you exactly how it works. Because of the way that we, because of our buying power, because of the amount of data that we buy from different sources, because we own the data, because we have all these relationships, we get our data at 20% of what it costs if you were to go out to other software packages like Perfect Audience or Retargeter or any of those others out there. They really don't do what we do, so you can't even get it there. But as far as showing the ads, if we were just to do, like, how do we show the ads and what does it cost, we get it for so much less that our profits are built into that $500, and it's all baked in so that nobody ever sees it. And so we just have like a small percentage that we tag under there so that we can stay alive, and you get to keep everything else above that. And so basically on all the reports, they see the $500 that they spent, and they're actually even getting better prices, even with our markup on there, than they can get anywhere else. So it's a win-win. So we can slide in our profits in there, so that we can stay alive and be your project managers and help you sell and all that kind of stuff. And the customer's paying that from the ad spend side, and you get to keep everything else. Sweet, right? So it's a win-win-win all the way around. Everybody survives and grows from this.
Chris, will you explain one more time? And I think you kind of did, but Francis in Ottawa, so he's in Canada, but he's trying to figure out, can he earn a monthly residual on his US clients?
Absolutely. So basically, what you can do for any of your US clients, let's just say you want to target, let's just say a restaurant, because we're kind of on that. You can do any type of business. You can do dentists, you can do doctors, you can do ophthalmologists, right? So basically, let's just use a restaurant, and it's in, say, Norfolk, Virginia. Say you have a client that's over there. You can target their business as you can target all of their competitors that are around them, because they're in the United States. So you can absolutely do that. Now, just to be clear, what we can do is if you have somebody who's in Canada, for instance, there's a restaurant in Toronto. We can't target that restaurant in Toronto because of the privacy laws that are in intact there. We can't target that restaurant or any of their competitors because of the laws that are there in any way, shape, or form. So that's what it is. So all of your clients that are in the US, it's fair game. Everybody's open. And we expect that Canada is going to relax those standards here pretty soon. And as soon as they do, we'll let everybody know.
Hey, Chris, let me hit you with two questions, and then I want to go to Owen's question. Adam said, Chris, I know there's sales material and all that inside. A lot of people commented on your slides. And Adam wants to know, what can he say to a prospect that says, how can you do this? You know, it's almost incredulous, right? So what is he, from a verbiage standpoint, how does he verbalize that in a way that connects with somebody that isn't super tech?
All right. So let's see, how do I do that without getting too technical? We're going to go over the how in our training. I mean, I'm going to go into like the nitty gritty details so that there's no wondering on your side exactly how this technical stuff works. It has to do with satellites. It has to do with cell phone triangulation. It has to do with basically apps that we have partnered with, 180,000 applications on people's phones. And so it gets kind of technical on that side. So I don't want to dive into it too much, but it is legit tech. It's not just like some kind of a repurposing of technology that's already out there. I mean, this is something that we, our company, and a couple other companies that are data providers that have certain abilities to do things, that we partnered in this to make this happen, because it's never been done like this before. Christine is saying it almost sounds sci-fi. Yeah, it does sound sci-fi until I'm going to tell you, I'm going to open the curtains for you so you can see how it works. And it's no joke technical. But the reason why I want to avoid this and why I've avoided all that throughout this discussion is because you don't need to know this. All you need to know is that it works and that we can target these people. Because if you start talking technical to your clients, and Brian knows this, the second you start talking about acronyms and technical stuff, their eyes roll back in their head and they won't buy from you because they get confused. So every step of the way throughout this process, you're not going to hear us talking about all the technology behind it, which is interesting and fun, but don't ever talk about this to your clients. All you have to do is say, we have a proprietary process that uses, you know, cell phones and targets where people go so that we can advertise to them. So keep it simple, because what they're looking for ultimately is the results. And they may be curious, and you know, it's not off limits, but man, be careful, because my experience, we've sold a lot of these. I've talked to literally thousands of store owners and business owners. Stay away from the tech. Just talk about how powerful it is and how it's going to revolutionize and change their business, okay?
Angus wants to know, Chris, is there a way that you track if the ads are actually working? Do you quantify results with the ads themselves?
Yeah, absolutely. So there's a lot of different types. Remember we talked about that measuring tape in the yellow slide? There's basically, in fact, let me jump back there real quick here. Let me go back to that slide so I can refer to it. It's a little bit back, but that's okay. There it is, right there. So we can measure this. Remember how we talked about measuring what the customers are interested in is super valuable. Are they trying to bring more people into their store? Do they want phone calls like a dentist? The dentist, they know that people are not just going to randomly walk in. What they want is phone calls to set appointments. Maybe it's a form fill for like a job application or something like that. Is it engagement? Like a politician, do they just want people to see them and their face? Maybe it's a real estate agent who wants people to see them in their face. So that would be impressions. But we measure all these things to make sure that we are being successful for that company. And your project managers will help you understand what that is by helping you ask the right questions to the customer so we can make sure that everybody knows when we're successful. Great question, though. Super great question. Thank you, Angus. How soon after the training can you offer this to your clients? You can offer it the same day. So basically, we definitely want you guys to go through the training first so that you can go out there well-equipped and very confident on what to say, what not to say, how to engage with your clients, and what it does, and more importantly, what it doesn't do, so that we're not promising things that it doesn't do, because it's, I'm not going to lie, it's a little sci-fi, right? But we'll talk to you guys about exactly how to position it and go through some scenarios on how to present this properly. And you guys have a great deck to kind of lead you along every step of the way, so you're not going to get too far off track.
Hey, quick shout out to Owen. Looks like it worked out, Owen. So good deal. Okay, so is it permission-based? Is it for the location tracking? Is it something a couple of people are asking, is this like, quote unquote, black hat, you know, if you will, is this all compliant legal is the concern? Yeah.
You know, that is such a great question, and I'm glad you asked that. Everything is above board, and it's really no different than if you went to Amazon and you're looking at, say, a pair of boots or a coat, right? And then later on, they're going back to you and saying, hey, how about you come back and buy these boots? It's really almost exactly the same, except for instead of going to Amazon, you went to a physical location, like a dentist or a yoga studio or a restaurant or, you know, a different place like that. So it's really, instead of virtually going somewhere, you physically went somewhere. So basically, this is the physical version of what Amazon and eBay and Zappos do. But it's like legit, Michael, or Michelle, I'm sorry. This is just, it's all been vetted out, and it's completely approved by the US government and all the governments of the countries that we're in. And we've spent an enormous amount of time with our legal counsel, as well as many lawyers in many different countries, to assure that this is above board and it follows all the privacy laws, which it does. Because ultimately, we don't know who is connected with these phones, nor do we care. We just want to make sure that the person who owns these phones see our ads. Simple as that. Great question. Is $1,000 a minimum campaign amount? No, it's not. You can change your profit margins on there as you see fit. But we recommend that you charge them $500 because you're worth it. This technology is worth it. So don't short sell yourself. I mean, you can do whatever you feel is appropriate, especially if it's like friends and family or whatever. But no, we don't tell you how much to charge for it. Now, the minimum of the campaign is $500 for ad spend, because what we found through our experience is that if you spend less than $16 a day, we can't get enough results to make optimization changes and to modify the ads when necessary and to run a good campaign. So basically, about $16 a day is what's kind of needed to run a good campaign. So that's why that $500 is there. And we've adjusted it over time, but this tends to be a really good low number for them to have good results. All right. How long does a typical campaign run? That is a great question. Thank you, Herb. Basically, what we like to do is do a 3-month test campaign. Like, we don't like to go in and do long-term commitments when they don't know how it's going to benefit their business. So we like to do a 90-day campaign, 3 months, because this is how it functionally works. The first month is setting up the campaign, getting all the ads put together, making them look great, connecting it to the right places, to the websites, wherever we want them to go, and then getting it started and targeting the audience and everything. So there's a lot of busy, getting put together stuff in the first month. And, no doubt we're marketing in the first month, but what we're doing is we're collecting data. The second month is when we have a certain amount of data collected, and we're still doing that from people who are engaging with the ads. And we start making alterations and optimizations where maybe we need to change the wording on the ad a little bit because not enough people are clicking on it and going to where we want them to go. Maybe not enough people are staying long enough on the website or the landing page, right? So we start looking at all the different engagements and what people are doing, but we start making optimizations. By the end of the second month, we have a really, really good idea that we're targeting the right audience, they're engaging at levels that we would expect them to at very high levels, and that the company is starting to experience good results. Now, the third month is when everything is firing on all cylinders. Now, we still continue to optimize, but we are pretty much there. We've dialed it in at that point, and the third month is where we have the best results, which allows the company to make a very good business decision to say, this is absolutely working for us because we're making $10 for every dollar we spend with you. And in the odd chance that they're saying, this just isn't working because we're not meeting the minimum threshold to be successful, that's where we shake their hand and we say, you know what? How about if we focus on Facebook or AdWords and we start directing them in another form of paid advertising that may work? Now, it doesn't happen often, but we don't want to hold them to something long-term if it's not absolutely working for them. That doesn't make for a good engagement or a good relationship. So we like to have you guys do just that 90-day test. And then after that, when it's working, you sign a 12-month commitment after that because everybody knows it's working. It's a no-brainer. Then you lock in 12 months of income at that point. And we'll help you do that. We'll get online with your customer and we'll tell them why it's in their best interest to pay you for the next 12 months to keep doing this. Cool, right? Herb is saying, hey, do you have case studies for the different niches? Absolutely. We have lots of case studies in the resources area where you can download it, and they're all white labeled. So you can show them with your company logo on it, or you can just leave it plain so they know where it came from. But that's all ready for you in the resources area. All right.
Guys, if we missed your question, there's a lot of them here and I got all the beams from earlier, but if we missed your actual question, will you put like a QQQ so Chris can see it or I can see it?
That is
what
a super
happens
good idea.
Is there's just so many, and it's honestly it's hard to see what we answered and didn't answer. Do you see Kurt, Chris? Kurt, I see yours.
Yeah, let me see this one. What does a campaign include? Multiple ads, landing page, how many ad size formats? Okay, great. Good question. So we're going to go into this all. We're going to go into all this on the training. But basically, what it includes is like you can get ads made anywhere. There's other marketers out there who have amazing ad making, the ads that we do for our clients. There's lots of ways you can get it done. You can get it done at $20 banners. You can get it done at Fiverr. You can get it done through software that's out there that you know some of our mastermind people have actually you know put together. There's lots of different ways. You don't have to have us do those ads. Now, if you want us to, we certainly can, and we do them by hand. It's not automated. We do it by hand, and we do them. We build those, and they're amazing. They're super high quality, and they're basically animated ads. So they move, and they have you know movement and things like that. So we do that stuff for you. We don't do the landing pages. We can if you want us to. There's great companies out there who do landing pages and websites. So, but that none of that is required. The only thing that's required to do your ad from our side is just to make sure that we can pay the websites and the applications to show the ads when our targeted people show up at their websites and use their apps. But we're gonna go through all that on the training so it'll be super clear on how that works. And you know, typically that stuff, it's not super expensive. It's just a one-time cost and you move past it, that kind of thing.
Chris, I see one. Biggie said, once more, I want to understand. She says, do we do anything other than simply close the client? And then do you guys kind of take over at that point from a back end process?
Yeah, that's correct. So what we need you for, let's talk about that just for a second, because this is important. Because, I mean, you are needed at a certain level at the very beginning, which is, you know, we need you to go out and basically spread the good news that this stuff is awesome and they can be done for them. Then what we do is we have a meeting with the customer, we close the customer, and then basically the project manager takes over from there because the relationship transfers from you to the project manager, and the project manager will connect with the customer on a regular basis. Now, that being said, the customer has a relationship with you too. So from time to time, they're gonna ask you a question and you can just relay it to us. We'll tell you what to say. Other than that, it's like you don't have to deal with this stuff on a daily basis. When we meet with the customer, you're welcome to be there, but you don't have to be. You don't want to.
Chris, I got a good one from Patty up in Chicago.
Yeah.
Patty said, what about with e-commerce? Could I advertise a sports-related item over, to people at a football stadium as an example?
Yeah. Let me tell you about a campaign. That is such a great question. Because yes, you can. And let me tell you how we've actually already done this. So we had somebody who does basically all the tchotchkes and stuff from universities. Like if you go to the University of Pennsylvania or Penn State or UCLA or you know all those you know colleges, what we did is we target every game that's out there, all the football games, all the basketball games, all that kind of stuff. And so they wanted to sell like, you know, the wristbands and the shirts and so they're licensed to do all this stuff for sure. But just all the different things like key rings and cell phone covers and all the stuff that have, you know, the college's, you know, brand and logos and stuff like that on there. So we targeted everybody who went to the games because who's the biggest fans of the college? They're the students and the people who go to the games, right? So that's what we did, and they were very successful in what they're doing, and they were definitely sending it to their e-commerce website. That's where the sales were happening. So absolutely.
Chris, so Doug up in Illinois, hey, Doug Starks, Doug said, do you recommend if the ad spend is $500, in that case, we should charge the clients $1,000 in that case to have $500 of profit?
Yes, that's correct. Because, you know, just mechanically to make this work, to make sure that your ads get out to the you know, websites and stuff, that $500, it covers just that expense, that cost to make it happen. Just like AdWords, you know, like when you pay Google to, you know, put the ads out there in front of the right people, it's the same exact thing. And then basically we call it, and we're going to train you how to do all this stuff. We have what we call a quote data cost. to target all these people and to, target them and pull in all this data from, different competitors and all this stuff. And then we have a small management fee. But honestly, that's all your money. We call it a data cost. So it basically offsets and they don't know how much money you're making. So you can say, hey, our management fee is like $200 per month, which is super reasonable, right? But you're really making the $300 that you're calling a data cost on your side too, because you get to keep all that. So we'll train you how to do all that stuff. But yeah, you'll want to market up to about $1,000 and you'll make $500 from that. And then it just goes up from there. If they spend more money, then you'll the data cost naturally goes up, which means that your profits go up.
Chris, what about Herb's asking if he goes to a local business, as an example, maybe a golf course, are you able to kind of quantify the target market, like saying, hey, the audience size we're going to go after is X or anything like that, so he can communicate with the business owner?
Yeah, typically you don't need to do that. But if you have like a large customer or something like that, we can do that for you. Like we did the US Open this last year. And so we were able to go through there and see how many people were there the year before and kind of pre-market to those people who went to the US Open the year before that. So yeah, we can definitely do that if you want to. But for most of the time, it's really not necessary because having a number is what? Kind of irrelevant. I mean, all they need to know is like we can target everyone who was in that area in that business for the last 12 months. So
I love that. Let's see. No, this is different than Peter is asking about J. Cruz's media stuff. This is very, very different, Peter. Completely different, honestly. No connection, but it's a good question. Michael said, okay, Chris, so my only hard cost is the front end. I don't have to sign up for a recurring. Nope. There's no other upsells or add-ons that I need. Michael,
there's nothing else to buy to make this work. Like there's no like upsells or anything like that. I mean, you get literally everything. This is a master account that you guys are going to get, and there's nothing else that's like locked into the system, something you can't get like training or anything like that. It's like, this is a wide open, you get everything that we have, one-time cost.
Chris, it's a good one from Walter. Walter's up in the Philly area, and he's talking about the COVID-19 impact and how it's limiting gatherings. So, no, for instance, no sports, no Eagles until next year, right, next fall.
That's right.
What's the COVID-19 spin, or do you have a COVID-19 spin for the customers that are the businesses that are feeling that impact?
You know, that is such a great question. And this is how we've kind of tackled that, because this is the question you're going to get from everybody. Nobody's been here for the last 3 months. How do you know? Well, the fact is that we have 12 months of data. So we have 9 months of valid data for people who've been in your location and your clients right now. Let's get them while we can. So you've got 9 months of really good data out there to fall back on. So that's what we need to focus on is, who's been there for the last 9 months? Well, we've been dormant for the last 3. Super great question, though.
Christine has a good one. Christine, remind me where you are. Are you Canada or are you UK? Christine said, and it's kind of a couple questions she asked, is exclusivity an issue depending on the business? And then the second one was, what about management fees for managing the ongoing account? How does that work?
Okay, so first of all, there's no management fees because remember, we get paid a little slice out of the ad spend, which just gets blended into all the ad spend. So there's no management fees for you. You get to keep all the management fees. So like if you charge your customer $500 to manage it, you keep all $500. You see what I mean? So we built this to make sure that you guys are as profitable as possible so that you don't, first of all, you're not spending time working on the campaigns. That's just it's interesting. But you're not building your company and you're away from your family when you're messing around with these campaigns. Let our project managers do all that for you. Leverage us so that you don't have to do this stuff. The second thing is, what was that second part, Brian? I know there's that.
Oh, talking about a management fee. She asked about a management fee.
Yeah, no management fee from our side. You get to keep the management fees that you target your client with.
Quick shout out to Bob McManus. Bob, welcome as well. Christine's up in Canada. I thought so, Christine. Okay.
Sweet.
Good one. Tito's Tito's Austin, Texas. I remember seeing you at the mini chat conference. Tito said, I'd like to get some help with political candidates in the coming months. Oh. Is that something we can work with and talk through?
Let me tell you just real quick how political candidates work, because this is super interesting for everybody. Political candidates, you know how they put out the signs all over the place, like on the corners and on fences and, you know, just all over the place, billboards, all that kind of stuff?
Yep.
How interactive are those signs?
Not very.
They're not, right? What if they were able to put those signs in front of all the different people that they want to get in front of, because they can pick their audience and they can click on that sign, AKA an ad online, and they can watch the videos and they can learn their positions and see how they're different from their candidates. How powerful is that? I'm telling you, it's powerful enough for Obama to win and for Trump to win, because this is what they were super good at in their campaigns. This is what won their campaigns, is by being able to be in front of people digitally, not physically. So this is how candidates win, is with this type of technology. When you can get, let me give you one example and then we'll move on from that, because it's endless. I mean, I can talk for hours about political campaigns. In fact, one of our trainings, we have training every week. One of our trainings, maybe we can talk just about political advertising. Here's one idea. You have a politician out there who has a very, very specific message for, say, Christians. Not all people who are religious, just Christians, right? If they were to put this ad out on a sign or on a billboard or on a commercial, there's a lot of people who are not Christians that this would not resonate with, if you know what I mean. In fact, it may crush them if they say certain things in a certain way. But what if you were able to use our technology and target every church, every Christian church, in the entire area that they have jurisdiction in? Maybe it's a county or a state or a city, that kind of a thing. What if we were to target every Christian church and then send a specific Christian message to those people? How powerful is that? What if we were going to get even more specific and say, I want every Armenian Christian church? And then they can have a specific Armenian looking person on the ad talking about this campaign or this candidate. So these are the people that are like them. These are the people they go to church with every week. So that's just one idea. I mean, there's tons of different places you can target to get these real niche types of people and send out really specific ads to them that will resonate with them, whether they're a college student or they're a professional that go to golf courses or to country clubs, or maybe it's their stay-at-home moms, things like that. I mean, there's just an endless amount of targeting that you can do so that you can really specialize your message that is just for them.
Hey, Chris, Patty, she's in. She loved the e-com.
Awesome.
Okay, so, and Peter Sangster, will let me get back to you on yours. Okay. Are they video ads or static kind of ads? Pat Coyle is asking.
Yeah, you can actually do both. In fact, you know, I didn't want to get too technical, but we can even get you on Hulu in streaming video as well, if you have a larger
client. That's awesome.
Seriously. And we can get you on the radio too. You want some radio spots to target these people? We can get you streaming radio spots on this too. I mean, I didn't want to get into it too much, but I'm telling you, we're going to blow you away when you get into this system and see the crazy technology and the things that you can do. It's like, it's unbelievable what we can do. But yeah, we can do video all over the place. In fact, video is super good for politicians, as you can imagine.
Super. Yeah, video is where it's at. I ended up getting 82% of the vote, and I got to tell you, a lot of it was because I was an incumbent and people are lazy and they just picked but video is the way. Video is where it's at. As long as you're not horrible on the video, you got to make sure it's not a bomb. You could sing yourself. Yep. Ken Fong. I'm going to double check with Chris, Ken, but that sounds correct. You should be good. Okay. Kim said, can I actually run it for our agency and then use myself as a case study?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, who better? It's always like one of those things where the first client, you can always use that as a cornerstone and say, look, we do this for this company over here. We work with Angela She's the owner of the company, and this is what happened when we lit this up for her. I mean, those are like some of the greatest testimonials, and you could say, how do you think you found me? You remember that ad that you clicked on to find me? How would you like me to turn around and put those ads out there for your clients so they'll click on it and find you? So yeah, I mean, it's what we call eating your own dog food.
That's right.
Right.
When you take care of your, you know, that proof point. Big shout out to Les in San Fran. Les, welcome. He's in. Okay. Christine, is there an option? Christine and a few others were asking about using PayPal. Is that an option, Chris?
Yeah.
Or is it?
Yeah. Okay. If you click on the link, the very first option on there is to pay using PayPal. So if you click on that, it'll take you a specific page that you pay through PayPal. Yep.
I love that. Okay. So Christine, let's see. Welcome, Christine. Also, Ken Fong is in. Welcome, Ken. Frank, the welcome tank back. Is the man. Can't read it. He sent me a private message, but I'll give you a thumbs up. Let's see. Okay. Gord said, kind of similar to what Kim asked, Gord Young said, could I use this kind of targeting to sell my own products? And I think the answer is absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, for sure.
All right, Ken, we got you. All right, once again, if we missed you, I only see a couple of people QQQ that I haven't answered. Go again. David Bennett, though, I see yours. How tightly, Chris, can we geo-target? For example, could you target everyone that visited a restaurant inside of a hotel? Could you, you know, what if it was a rooftop bar in a hotel? All kind of various crazy ideas. Is there the ability to be spatial like that to kind of go lat long? You know, how do you do that?
Yeah, so basically we have the ability to draw like any shape that we want to target. So if it's like in a weird building, or we only want like part of a building, like in Las Vegas, we targeted all of the different conference centers there. So we literally went on top. We use Google Maps as a visual representation of where we want to target. And we found out where all the conference centers were, and we literally just like drew lines around those conference centers in whatever shape that they were. So we can be very accurate, and it's accurate down to 20 feet is what our experience is. Like literally when we were putting this together, we would set up these parameters, and I would literally walk into my like parking lot from my office, and it would trigger. So I would walk a certain distance from my desk into the parking lot, and boom, it would trigger. So what we found is it's like 20, 25 feet as far as accuracy.
I love it. Okay, so no, that was super cool. Talking about closing the customer earlier on, and Kurt was asking this. I missed it, Kurt. Sorry. Early on, you mentioned even helping closing. Could you talk about that, Chris? Are you serious, or is that just something you said as you were going through the webinar?
No. Our project managers, because they're going to be taking care of you, you're going to get to know them. Like when you engage with your first project, you're going to be assigned a project manager, and that project manager is going to be assigned to all your future projects as well. So you're going to get to know them. They're going to get to know you, and you're going to have this comfort level where you're going to want them. I mean, you're going to want to set up the calls and stuff, but you're going to have like their calendar so you can book them to be on the call when you're selling. And sometimes it may even be me that's jumping on with you so that we can go in and we can kind of explain how it works, answer any questions, things like that. Because, you know, we know how it feels when you get on with somebody that you're nervous with and that you're kind of putting yourself out there. But what if you had me on the line with you as you were approaching your client? You think that you could probably close a couple of sales? I'm telling you, we could close a couple of sales together. And our project managers are every bit as good as I am, maybe even better, because they do this all day long. Like, I don't manage projects all day long. I mean, I set up the technology, but they do all the project management stuff. And so these are the people that you're going to have on your team that can work with you on landing clients and then taking care of them after you land it. And they'll have that relationship from the very beginning when they learn about this.
Okay, Dr. Walker, I saw her post this in one of our other groups. So super cool. First of all, congrats. She got a big deal. With a client that does antibody tests for doctors. Can she market the antibody testing? How would you like, where would you target, Dr. Walker? I think Chris is going to tell you the answer is yes, but I'm curious kind of where you're thinking for it. Would you do doctor's offices, or what are you thinking on that? Let's see. and we'll come back to you, but I wanted to get that out for Chris. What about Gord? Gord's up in Canada, wants to know. Mm-hmm. He'd love to go after U.S. clients because he loves the service. He's like, could I simply use a phone person to kind of help take the calls? Chris, yeah. You don't have to. Remember, wait a minute. Gord, you don't have to. Remember, Chris said you can be in Canada and work with U.S. clients. You just can't work with Canadian clients.
That's right. That's exactly right. Let me go back to the last question real quick because I think there's something interesting there. So we are currently marketing for these antibody tests. In fact, the company that we're working with, they sold 30,000 of those today, just today in Kansas City, Missouri. So I know that it works because we did it. And,
I love that.
They're not doing it widespread all over the United States. They're focusing just on Missouri right now.
Yeah, Chris, Dr. Walker wants to do more clinics and hospitals.
Clinics and hospitals, that's right. And we have ways that we can target doctors specifically. And we'll go into this on our training. Remember the audiences and the different things? We can target the doctors in those offices, not their patients. So if you want to target doctors and their staff, we can do that. And that's exactly what we're doing with their audiences as well. We're targeting doctors and their staff.
Chris, here's a good one about attorneys from Dr. Christ. He said, can we target all cell phones in a hospital waiting room a day or two later, wherever they are after they left the emergency room? Is that possible?
Yeah, absolutely. In fact, from our experience, it's actually a little bit longer than that. So we can target them while they're in the hospital. And we actually do the entire hospital because what happens is they're only in the emergency room for a short time, then they go to a bed. They're usually in the bed. The best cases are in a bed for like weeks. So what we found is that targeting the entire hospital is actually more desirable for the law firms. And then also what we found is that somewhere between 2 and 4 weeks is the sweet spot for targeting them because their insurance hasn't hit yet. They're busy like kind of recovering from, you know, their injuries and things like that. And they haven't felt the impact of the economic impact into their lives yet until about around week two. So we like to wait a week, maybe 2 weeks, maybe even 3 weeks before we start showing the ads. But we can, you know, your project managers can talk all about that. We can go through that on the weekly training and talk all about that as well. It's a very, very interesting process.
Chris, here's a new one from Michelle. Does your system allow us to define a geolocation for where prospects have actually been in the past, frequented in the past, as well as a geolocation for where and when we want to display ads to them?
Yeah, we can do both, but I'm not quite sure why you'd want to do the second. So yeah, absolutely. That's kind of what we're talking about here, which is, have they gone to this location in the past? If so, those are our people. That's who we want to see our ads. So that's absolutely what we're doing here. Now, if you have an area where you say, I only want to display the ads if they're in a certain area, like for instance, let's use an example, like you're targeting everybody at a sporting event, but you only want to market to people who go back to a certain city. Absolutely. And so that's a great way that we can target them, like because people from other cities go to this sporting event, but you know, your business is in a city and you don't care about the cities next door, right? So yeah, we can definitely only show ads in the city that you're interested in or the community or just even a smaller area. So we can do that. And your project managers will help you understand the right way to do that so you don't stub your toe on that and you have the effects that you're looking for.
Chris, here's a good one. Christine asking about time commitment. Realistically, what is the time commitment? Somebody gets in, let's say they land a client. When they do the handover to the project manager, what would be her time commitment in that case?
You know, I think it depends. It's honestly, it comes down to how much time you choose to spend with them because, you know, we don't want you to abandon your customers for sure because nobody has a better relationship than you do with your customers. So we like you to reach out to them on a semi-regular basis, like, you know, a couple times a month just to call and say, hey, how's it going? Is there anything we can do for you? I'm looking forward to meeting with you at the end of month so we can go over your project, things like that. And it doesn't have to be in person or anything like that, but we like you to reach out to your customers every once in a while just to kind of say, hey, we're alive and we're working on your stuff. Now, remember, your customers are going to be able to see their reports anytime during the month. But we have live reporting that they can look at anytime they want. And so from time to time, they may reach out to you for a question or something like that. But honestly, it's going to be pretty minimal. There's some people who like to engage a lot more than others, but it's totally your choice.
All right. Shout out to Steve. Steve, are you in Austin or Australia? So welcome, Steve. He's in. He's got a new startup, Steve Cameron. Let's see. Herb said, are you saying I can target certain types of business owners? So in this case, I can target a bankruptcy attorney or multiple bankruptcy attorneys in the state of North Carolina because my client wants to go after those prospects.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So your project manager can help you to see what audiences that are out there. We have lots and lots of professional audiences that are out there. And honestly, we get them from LinkedIn. So if somebody is on LinkedIn and says, I am a lawyer or I am a doctor or that's where we're getting the information from. So it's pretty darn accurate because they put it on LinkedIn. This is what I do. So that's matched up and that's where we get our data from is LinkedIn in that case. So yeah, your project managers can help you find those specifically so you can target just the people that you want to.
All right, and that's Steve in Australia, just north of Sydney. So welcome to Steve. All right. So from a cost standpoint, Traffic Legend is asking, how does your advertising costs compare to a targeted ad from using Facebook as an example?
Okay. So here's another thing too that I wasn't really planning on covering today, but I'm just touch on it just like a pogo stick. I'm just going to bounce off of this one. We can put your ads on Facebook. That's all I'm going to say about it. Because
nice.
we can take these audiences, we can put them in Facebook, and you could do Facebook advertising. So we're going to go over that in all the training. It's going to blow your mind, I'm telling you guys. But here's the bottom line. Our typical ad spend right now is about $6 to $7 CPM, which is for every 1,000 ads, it costs $6 to $7. On Facebook, it's between $12 and $13 right now. So Facebook is almost twice as much, but I'm telling you, it's worth every penny you spend on there. So we'll go over all the details on Facebook. It's kind of a different animal because they're legit Facebook campaigns that we're running. But we'll go through all that. I'm telling you, there's so much tech in here. Every time that you meet with us, your mind is going to be blown all over again through the training on what we can do and how specific we can get and where we can target them.
I love it. Okay, so shout out to David Bennett. He's in, so welcome, David. Chris, David, his question, though, his add-on after he signed up is, how soon can he get it up and running? What's the lead time?
So that's a great question. So basically, let's just say your landing page or your website, it's already done. You already have ads created or you're going to get them done tomorrow. It's literally you can get it running in the same day. So we have and it's a monumental process. I'm not trying to downplay this at all. We have 64 ad networks that have to approve your ads. It's no joke. But we have it down to a fine-tuned process now so that literally within a few hours, those ads can be approved and you can be showing it to your targeted audience. Honestly, what takes the longest time is getting the ads put together and your landing page put together if it's not already done. That's usually what takes the most time. It's not getting the project working. The project, your project managers are very efficient and they can get these things going very quickly for you.
All right, so let's see. Gord, who's up in Canada, said, can we do targeting using LinkedIn? Can we use LinkedIn as any part of the process to kind of narrow in on people? So Gord, tell us more about what you're thinking. I think the answer is yes.
It's actually yes in two different ways. Now these are not LinkedIn campaigns that you can go to LinkedIn and pay for campaign in there, but LinkedIn does show these ads. And we also use data from LinkedIn to show ads to other people that are not on LinkedIn as well. So it goes both ways.
I love that. Okay, so Peter, also in Australia, who'd signed up, he says good day to Steve. I love it. All right, glad to connect you guys. Kurt said, Kurt, let me let Chris take that one offline. I don't know the answer, and I don't want to confuse other people on that one. Let's see. Kim said, what about ad templates? Kim Armstrong. So when she gets a client, does she have to design the ad? Is there a template? How is the actual creation of the ad handled is her question.
So say that one more time. What was the question?
Oh, it was ad templates. So imagine she got a new attorney. Is there some examples or templates she can use? Yeah. Does she have to design it? How does that work?
Yeah, so we have, if you want to do it yourself, there's ad templates all over the internet. You really don't need to get them from us, but we do have a few that you can use if you'd like. It's in the resources area.
Okay, Willie, who's out, I believe in Las Vegas, Willie, right? Willie Reese. And Willie was one of the Amazon winners tonight. Willie said, Chris, I want to make sure that you said no technical skills required. I bring the client and the project management and your team will do the back end work.
That's correct. And we'll even help you with the sale. So all you have to do is kind of like briefly explain, like, we can target your competitors' people that go to their stores. You should hear my project manager talk about it. Let's get a phone call together so you can hear how this all works. That's it. There's no tech involved with that. And then, of course, when the project manager gets on, they'll do all the work. They'll do, you know, all the customer phone calls to explain how it's working and how successful it is and what the numbers mean and all that stuff.
So Brad is asking, if our client definitely wants to have Facebook included, does that raise the minimum spend because just the Facebook costs, or is that going to be included in at the minimum ad spend at 500?
Yeah, you know, that entails a longer conversation. You know, Facebook is its own animal and we'll talk about all the details, but it's entirely doable. It's not crazy, but it is handled differently because Facebook handles things differently than the traditional ad networks and stuff like that. But we'll go into all those details. I mean, it's totally sick.
I gotta give a shout out to Willie in Vegas. Willie said, dopest dope I've ever smoked. Willie, I've never said those words together, but I had to say it out loud. And I love it. Okay, Christine said, can the joint call be done with Zoom or Skype with the prospect?
Yeah. No, absolutely. Yeah, we have Zoom accounts that we use for all that. And also we live on Skype. So if you guys Skype, that's the preferred method of conversation or communicating with your project managers, for sure.
That's awesome, Chris. All right. Hey, if we missed you, remember QQQ again. I'm not trying to ask you to retype it, but if I didn't read yours out or Chris didn't get it or we didn't answer you privately, will you ask us again? There's still a lot of people here. If I missed you for the link with the beam, go ahead and tell me again and I'll give it to you. As we're moving towards the end, I don't want to leave anybody out. It's kind of a real low-key call. I think you guys get you get the sense, just like I already know, Chris is the real deal. I've known him a long, long time. Definitely, out of all the marketers I know, he's got more of an agency base, more clients than most of them put together. So everything you're listening, if you think somebody said, God, this guy's so, it's just, he's a straight shooter. And I think that's probably the right word to sum him up. Okay, here we go. I got a few of them coming in. Beam, I'm going to get the beams to you. All right. I love this. I'm going to say it for Chris from my friend Herb. Can we target females in a dormitory or on a college campus? And he says, Herb says, I think you'll get the angle I'm thinking of, Chris.
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah, we can definitely do that. And I'll just leave it there.
There you go.
No, yeah, we can absolutely do that. No joke.
Jeff Jackson, I just sent it over to you, Jeffrey Jackson. I got Dennis as well. And guys, we're almost, we got to be near the limit. I've done a lot of beam in here. Okay. Yeah. What Christine said, when does the training start, Chris? When's the first training call? Had it up a minute ago and I forgot.
Yeah. In fact, you're going to know about it because if you signed up, your thank you page has a sign up for the training. So make sure you do that. Also, every one of you guys are going to be our Elite 50 that we're going to be working with. What we're going to do is send you an email probably tonight or tomorrow sometime, welcoming you and also ensuring that you have the link to the training on July 21st, which is Tuesday. at 11 o'clock. And if you can't make it, we totally understand. We record those and we'll send you out the replays so that you can watch those. And then there's also a bunch of other training that you're going to have access to once you get into the system as well. So you can even watch like, you know, 10 different training sessions before we even have this one if you want to. It's if you're in your system, it'll be on the left side under training and resources, and you'll see all the videos on there. You can't miss them. There's like 30 or 40, you know, weekly trainings that are up there.
Chris, Traffic Legend, good add on to Herb's question about college campuses. He said, What about CBD? Is there any limitation to CBD related advertisements?
Actually, we have 9 ad networks that are approved for CBD advertising. So if that's something you want to do, it's absolutely legit to do that. Now, there's certain limitations that we have as far as what you can say on the ads and stuff like that. Your project managers will lead you through that process. But yeah, we can do CBD online.
Michael St. Marie up in Michigan. Hey, Michael. Once again, I am, he's just asking, I'm not responsible for ad creation or website design or things like that. I bring the client fulfillment handled on the back end.
Yeah, so let's be clear about that because it needs to be done. So you're going to need to coordinate with the client or we can, it doesn't matter. We prefer you do it because you need to make money off of it. So we can do the ads for you. We can do the landing pages if you want to. It's just a one-time fee. Your project manager can help you with that, or you can get it done with somebody else who's like you like. Like if you have a landing page creator that you guys love, we work with them to get these set up for the client. Like we don't care who you work with. It's not a big like revenue generator for us. It's basically a necessary evil to get it done so we can get the ad campaigns working, kind of a thing. So. But yeah, the ads are done. Your project manager can help you coordinate that.
Personal injury side, I didn't promote this. I don't know if you did. It just didn't fit with what I'm doing right now. But Joe Troyer and our friend Rob Warner, man, they put out a really. You guys ever want the real world stuff? You know what I mean, like the straight stuff. Well, those products never sell a million copies, right? Because it's straight shooter stuff. If you haven't seen it. Go find somebody. I think Zach Anderson. I don't know, Chris, if you were promoting it or Gene Calenda was promoting it. Joe Troyer.
It is
really, really good, you guys, on landing pages for PI. And if the price jacked up, hit me up and I'll get you a backdoor link for whatever the discount was. Like I said, I didn't promote it, but I have it now. So I weaseled my way into a copy. Man, is it good. You got to see it if you're doing PI attorneys. If that's something you're doing. Okay. Let's see. Where is the PayPal link? The Buddha. Hey, Buddha. Good to see you.
All right. So let's actually go there. Let me share out my screen real quick. And let's go to the chat right here. Let's just go through. I'm going to exit the show right here. I'm going to go back here. Let's just go over here. And let's open up the order page. So like when you click on the Tractor Beam, you see this button right here where it says order using PayPal. If you click on this right here, it's going to go to a page right here that's PayPal payment. And you can just fill out these items right here and you can choose PayPal. So yeah, just go to the order page. In fact, I'm going to paste it in right here. So we're doing exactly what you're doing. When you go here, just click this button right here. Where it says order using PayPal and you're good to go.
Easy. I love it. All right, I'm going to hit
you. The top 50? I don't know. I've been paying attention. Maybe.
Yeah, I haven't looked. We'll check it. So,
if you order right now, you made it in. If the order form goes away, then that means you missed it. So if you're seeing the order form when you click the link, I'm going to put it into the chat window right here.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, I'm beamed out, you guys. I think I did 300 or 400 copy paste. Makes me think I need to have Vanessa on these calls at night. Chris, Bob McManus, he came on board earlier, but when you know, after the call, if you get a second look at it, he's concerned that he may have accidentally bought twice or something, or even multiple times.
No, Bob, we'll take care of you.
Don't worry about it, Bob. We'll fix it for sure.
It's not a problem at all. We have great staff. Francie will help get all that taken care of. So don't worry about that at all. Not a problem.
Yeah. Adam Griffin said that PI Smart Pages jacked up to $200 So if you guys want it, you're doing PI and you want to pair it with what this is, let me know. I'll get some kind of backdoor link from Joe and give it to you guys. Or okay, Steve Cameron got in on PayPal. Okay. Nichol said, I need to speak to a decision maker who is asleep in his time zone. I hope to make for the offer when he's awake. Nichol, that sounds good. Let's see. No, Chris has not given the ebook out. He will, Doug Starks. And somebody else asked about that, Willie. What about ad sizes? Yeah, what about display sizes?
Oh, okay. I'll talk about that. Real quick on the ebook side. When you come onto the training, we're going to give you a white label version of that that was built in Microsoft Word. So you can put your own branding all over it, your own contact information, and print it out as a PDF and give that out. So everybody who attends, actually, you know, everybody who joins, you're going to get that. So you have your own white label. As far as ad sizes, we build ad sizes for mobile and desktop. So no matter what device they're on, they're going to see ads all over the place in all the right places. So that typically consists of four main ads. It's a 320 by 200 or 300 by 250. It's going to be a 728 by 90. It's going to be a 160 by 600 and a 468 by 60. And I know I just went through all the technical stuff that I promised I wouldn't do. But your project managers will help you with all that stuff. They're all the major, most popular ad sizes that show up on most websites because they fit best on the websites.
I love it. Okay. Anybody else? I think, let me check. I think we got them all. My favorite is Herb's question about females in a dormitory on a college campus. I love it.
Good one.
All right. If we missed your question, this is your time. There's honestly, there's been very little drop off on the webinar. And I think we all know why. You got a cutting edge technology. Right, bleeding edge even, but it's been out a little bit. Chris, you've been working with this for some time. This didn't come out a week ago, right? You've been using this,
yeah. And
it's matured, I think, over the last bit. Matter of fact, it probably works better today than it did when it first came out.
Yeah, absolutely. We're constantly adding on new technology. In fact, Facebook is brand new to us. You guys are the first ones to hear it, actually. We brought this on about 3 weeks ago and started testing it on our side. And so we know that it works right now, and the results so far have been outstanding. And so the reason why I haven't mentioned it until just today is because, you know, it hasn't been tested up until this last week, and we have a high level of confidence that this is going to work outstanding. From everything that we've seen so far, the campaigns that we're running, they're outstanding. And so we'll talk about that more as time goes on. But yeah, we're constantly adding new technology and new ways of targeting and learning as we go. But like you've seen those customers, they didn't come overnight. We've been doing this for about a year and a half, almost 2 years now. And we keep it kind of tight knit because we can only work with so many people. That's why we limited it to 50 so that we can make sure we can spend adequate time with you guys and make sure we're paying attention to your campaigns and you and helping you sell and things like that.
All right. I'm going to bang out a couple fast ones, Chris, to you. So Dr. Christ loves it. Should help everybody's retirement plan. I love that. Okay, Michael up in Michigan said, how long to really learn this so I can make sales and generate revenue? You know, what's the learning curve for him?
You know, that's a super important question. You should be able to leave our training that we're going to have, which is going to be 1 hour long, and be able to feel comfortable to go out and start presenting this to your contacts and the people that you want to talk with.
All right, I love it.
Because remember, this is not going to be technical.
I love Brad Dixon. My friend Brad said, Brian, will there be a replay? I just got here. Brad, absolutely. Looks like we have a replay and we will get it. It'll probably be mid-morning East Coast time because I've been up like 15 hours and I'm just going to do it in the morning, or Vanessa will. We'll get it out to you though. Patty in Chicago said, Chris, where have you been hiding? This tech sounds awesome. And I agree with Patty. I mean, it was like, wow. All right, let's see. Anybody else? Oh, Patty says, Chris, just curious, what part of the world are you located in? How big is your team? All that kind of stuff.
Good question. So our team, I think we have 8 people on the team right now. And so we're small enough where we're agile, but we're big enough to take care of everything that's coming in. And our offices are in Arizona. So yeah, all of our project managers are in Arizona. So if you guys want to come visit us. Awesome. Well,
Chris, you're not far from Jeff Hershey. Everybody's shelter right now.
Yeah, yeah. I'm about 15 minutes away from Jeff Hershey. Yeah.
Very cool. Yeah, our Sandra said, wow, this is awesome. Michael said, good answer. That's what he was looking for. Excellent. And all right. Buddha said, can I use Groove Pages, Groove Funnels? You absolutely could for landing pages, Buddha. But what I would do is I would find a converting one first that you want to design there. But we can take it offline on that. Let's see. Stay safe, social distance in Arizona. We got a bunch of feedback there.
Yeah, it's a zombie apocalypse over there. So.
Yep, Patty and Michael, I'm going to connect. And Patty, I'm going to connect you two together. Michael just messaged me. All right. Chris, I think, did I miss anybody? This is my going once, going twice. This is my last time. Did we miss you guys? Because it's been a great presentation. Let's see.
All yeah, right. If you guys have any questions, reach out to us at support@trafficoxygen.com. It goes into our ticketing system, so our team will be able to answer those for you. But yeah, if you have any questions or concerns, or you just want to chat or whatever, support@trafficoxygen.com. We'd love to talk with you.
I love it. Peter's super happy. Cynthia Hoyt said thanks to Chris and Brian. We're going to do, for everybody that gets on board, we're going to do a few bonuses. I'm going to put an email together to everybody who bought tomorrow, and we'll just call them a little surprise bonuses for all of you guys. And you'll get an email after we get the list from Chris. He's on, are you Pacific or Mountain right now, Chris?
Pacific.
You're Pacific. So yeah, it'll be noon to 2 o'clock. We'll get it out in the afternoon to you guys. We'll put some cool bonuses together for you, for everybody that came on board. Gord said, I'm in. I'm super excited. Believing with that, guys, this has been really, really cool. You'll see, think about the offer for a minute. So you got this very affordable, yet in my mind, like seemingly cutting edge tech, right? You've got no ongoing commitment from a cost standpoint, no upsell, no additional costs. At the end of the day, not having to do the fulfillment, 70-odd% of you answered on the survey. That's what you were looking for. And I knew in my heart that it was a number up there. So when I chatted with Chris the other day, I said, listen, the DFY angle is so important right now, maybe more than ever. And I just knew this was the right fit at the right time with the right unique kind of product that'll turn heads. Doesn't matter. People have seen a lot of things, right? But they can't even begin to imagine. You guys are all really savvy marketers. I want you to think at the beginning of the call, as Chris is going through this and your jaws are dropping, I'm watching from the comments how amazed everybody was. Imagine the small business owner who he gets mystified by a lot of the simpler things. This is truly next gen stuff. And I got to tell you, Chris is the right guy for this. He's got a tech team. He's got a lot of developers. He's got a lot of support staff. If you don't have your own team and you don't have a lot of help, this is the kind of product that maybe will turn the corner for you. Make sure it fits. Remember, if you're in the UK and Canada, you can't sell clients in those markets. But Chris is very clear. We've got a lot of members in those two countries that are selling out elsewhere, Australia, US, wherever it may be. So thank you very much, Chris.
You're very welcome. It's super great to be with you guys.
Brad joined us at 10. He's been here 8 minutes. He says, I'm about to join, Brian. What's the ongoing cost? I'm going to defer to Chris on that, Brad.
Yeah, there's no ongoing cost. It's one time you get a master membership, and it's a lifetime account. So good question, Brad.
No, thank you, Brad. And Brad, I saw Paul recently, who was at Marketer Mansion with me and you together way back when. He lives near me. Willie said, Chris, thank you so much for your time. He is getting in tonight, and I love it. Hey, if you guys would you leave just a couple words on what you thought about the webinar? You don't have to press one or anything silly like that. Just share what you think of Chris, the webinar. Just share it, and I'm going to email it over to Chris because I want him to know we really appreciate it. It's for him, it's the middle of his dinner, early evening with his family, and I'm really grateful he took that time.
Thank you, Brian. I appreciate that.
No, for sure, man. Totally. And I'm bummed. I know we were going to, I love it. I'm seeing the comments. Outstanding. Amazing. Guys, so Chris and I were meeting up in London in May. Obviously, that didn't happen with everything going on. And even our fall meeting, Chris, sounds like we might end up doing Zoom to be smart, or maybe a real small group somewhere. Yeah. But just crazy.
Yeah,
guys, it's tough. Dr. Walker said, everyone, this solved my biggest issue. Project manager in ads. I really appreciate you. Willie said, I think you're crazy letting go of this stuff the way you do, but I love it. Kurt said, great presentation. Cool tech. Amazing what you can do. James, Michael, Dr. Michael said, this is good enough to buy twice. Michael up in Michigan. Now, Michael's got an amazing story. Worked at a furniture company for many, many years. COVID and a number of other reasons, the business is closing down or recently closed down. So he's been making massive transitions. He's like, I love it. I think I can actually do this. Gord, who's in Canada, I'm still here. I'm excited. Sounds too good to let slip by. This is one of those things that when I see it, I've seen it, you know, obviously Chris has showed me before. I just go, wow. Steve said, fun webinar. Steve in Australia, outside of Sydney. Cynthia Hoyt, super excited. Adam said, thanks, guys. I can't wait to Tuesday. Awesome. Patty said, I'm going to end with Patty. Patty bailed me out at my very first event. Mario Brown and I didn't know our, you know what, right? We couldn't get name tags to work right. Patty, like, came in, pushed us out of the way, took over, and made everything work. And I want to say, Chris, she said, this sounds like the perfect way to help businesses that are hurting. Thanks for the great presentation and avoiding making it too techy. So super cool. I love it. Thank you, Chris.
And very kind words. Appreciate it.
Everybody. Well, with that being said, I know we're at 10:15. Gary Herter said, I just joined. I may be the last one. Gary? Welcome, and we're glad you stuck around, and we're glad you came on board.
Thanks, Gary. Great working awesome. With you.
Well, listen, Chris, I will go home and do my regroup and check in with Rebecca and all that stuff. And I got to tell you, very cool. And I'll see you guys on the training. We will get the replay out. And for everybody that came on board, got a few bonuses. I'm gonna keep a mystery. I'm gonna let Vanessa mock the page up. I've already sent them over to her, and you guys will get an email and an invite for that. I love it. Well, thank you very much, Chris. And I will chat, I imagine, very soon.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. Have a great
day. See you, everybody. Bye.
Thanks, Brian. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.